definitely Europe and the world in the 21st century.
Hvala, mr. Ljubljana, gospoda Zoran.
Thank you very much, Mr. Figueroa, for these beautiful, extremely encouraging words. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let us welcome the mayor of the city of Ljubljana, Mr. Zoran Jankovic.
Excellence, dame, gospodje, drage sodelavke, sodelavci.
Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues.
Prvo pa vedel sem komisarju gospodu Figu na uvodnih besedah, kaj sedaj lahko zmerno veselo rečem, drage dame, gospodje, dobrodošli v Ljubljani, v najvišjem mestu na svetu.
I'm extremely grateful to Commissioner Figuel for his words in his introductory address, which enables me to easily say to you, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Ljubljana, the most beautiful city in the world.
Ljubljana postaja, oziroma je postala spremljanjena predstavnica Združene velike enotne Evrope.
Ljubljana has now become a capital city of a united, bigger Europe.
Na eni strani moramo spoštovati to enotnost, na drugi strani pa moramo spoštovati raznolikost, različnost narodov in različnih kultur.
On one hand, we need to respect the unity, on the other, diversity of different nations and different cultures.
In če želimo to spoštovanje skozi v praksi, potem moramo to različnost spoznati in tudi dojeti.
And if we wish to express this respect in practice, we need to understand and learn more about this diversity.
In tudi v naši dan je cilj od tega, da spoznavamo različne kulture, da spoštujemo ta naš medkulturni dialog in da spoznavamo to v praksi, da smo eni drugi prijatelji, da se razumemo, da se spoštujemo, da spoštujemo toleranco, da spoštujemo tudi različnost.
And today, this is the very purpose of our meeting, to show our respect for culture, for intercultural dialogue, for doing it in practice, to really become friends in order to respect each other and show great tolerance.
In če primerjam evropske glavne mesta, potem lahko ugotovim, da Ljubljana za to danes spoštuje.
And comparing the capital cities of Europe, I can easily say that Ljubljana has shown that respect already.
In potrebnost v dialogu vidim tudi v prihodnosti Združene Evrope.
And the need for dialogue is something I greatly see for the future of Europe.
In ravno s tem namenom bomo tu, na Ljubljanskem gradu, pripravili srečanje županov vseh glavnih mest Evropske unije in tistih, ki čakajo dostop v Evropsko unijo, ter treh iz bivše Jugoslavije na temo medkulturni dialog.
And today, this is our purpose as mayors signing this declaration to actually light the candles for all who are going to follow with their signatures, since there are many mayors present here, including three coming from the former, from the countries of former Yugoslavia, and those who are already, who are still waiting to be full members of the European Union.
Kaj ti prepričan sem, da glavna mesta, ki najbolj potrebujejo in tudi najbolj vzkazuje, in če bomo mi našli pravo pot, potem bo pot za vse državne Evrope veliko lažje.
And I'm convinced that this is exactly what all the capital cities of Europe need, and if we show that way, it will be much, much easier for all of us.
Vesel sem vašega prihoda.
Good afternoon, friends. I have a speech ready, but I propose that I put it on the website. If you can all read on that, then very shortly and very long if you want. Because what my president said, what Mr. Figel said, what the mayor said, is of course what I will say also. And I'm sorry, I give you my text, you know, as well as I am. We are very proud, of course, as a European Festival Association, that we can organize this. Some elements have to be pointed out.
Dragi prijatelji, dovolite, da ne glede na to, da sem govor res odlično pripravil pisni obliki, da ga zaenkrat pustimo na strani, lahko se ga boste ogledali na spletnih straneh EFE. Pomembno je namreč, da se tudi sam navežem na besede gospoda Župana, gospoda Figela in gospoda Brlaka, ki so me tako zelo navdihnili, kaj ti pozoriti ne želim na nekaj strani.
Of course, for festivals, as for all cultural associations, two important elements are there, as art, artists and public.
Tisto, kar je izrednega pomena za vse festivale in kulturna združenja, pa je, da je umetnost tista, ki je vedno na prvem mestu.
But as an association for festivals, with the members and with non-members of the European Festival Association, we are absolutely also concerned that this responsibility gives us a wider responsibility in society, so that we have also take our responsibility in a society as art organization, as festivals.
Kot združenje pa se s temi besedami navezujem na tako člane kot ne člane našega združenja. Mislim, da je izrednega pomena, da prevzamemo to odgovornost na področju kulture tudi v širšem družbenem smislu in bomo s tem zagotovili naše boljše delovanje.
That's the reason why the European Festival Association, with their members and also with non-members, we want to be an open association for festivals in Europe and abroad, where we work 1 year long in consultations, in meetings, to make this declaration ready. And we are very happy that we can sign today the Arts Festival Declaration of Intercultural.
V tej prihodnosti leži razlog, zakaj se je EFA tako s svojimi članicami, tudi nečlanicami, vse čas opozarja tudi na naše nečlanice, ki z nami sodelujejo, kajti naše združenje želi vedno ostati odprto. Torej, celo leto smo se trudili in oblikovali besedilo deklaracije, za katero je sedaj na početku tega podpišeno.
It's for us a very important moment. It's a moment, but a very important one. But not only the most important starts today. So I invite you also to follow the European Festival Association, mostly through our website, how we will work with the declaration and how we will invite other festivals to come with us and to sign up the declaration, and most of all, to work in the spirit of the declaration.
Live with that.